بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، أرحم الراحمين، نور السماوات والأرض، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهدي الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله، إمام المرسلين وخاتم النبيين وصفوته من الخلق أجمعين، سيدي سادات العرب والعجم، فخر ربيع ومضر، فيا أيها الراجون شفاعته أكثروا من الصلاة عليه. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. امتدت عين بنظر ووعت أذن بخبر وقطرت السماء بمطر. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. أما بعد، praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one we ask help, mercy, forgiveness, and we seek refuge with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the bad deeds of ourselves and the evil of our souls. Whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided will never be misguided. But whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala leave to be stray, abandoned, leave them in charge of their own self, they'll never be guided. They are in a serious trouble. I bear witness there's no Lord or deity worthy to be worshipped but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one and only one. And Muhammad, peace be upon him, his servant, his messenger, the best and purest of Allah's creation, the face of glad tidings, the sweetheart for the good hearts, for the good people. As to follow my brothers, my sisters, dear believers, the best greeting of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to all of you, and upon all the bright faces that make sujood to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to all the sincere hearts that finds comfort, happiness, satisfaction, content, trust, success with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Today's topic, today's reminder, it is a serious, dangerous matter. I will be talking in Arabic and English, so those who only speak English will understand. Those who only speak Arabic, inshallah, will understand. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala declared in the Quran, وَإِنَّ عَلَيْكُمْ لَحَافِظِينَ كِرَامًا كَاتِبِينَ يَعْلَمُونَ مَا تَفْعَلُونَ. Closest to the meaning, verily upon you appointed angels, kind and honorable, they write your deeds and they know what you are doing. So this is a precise pinpoint, what? Pinpoint monitoring from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Precise monitoring from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who does not fall asleep. Dear believers, today's khutbah, today's speech about alahma bila idham, walakinaha tukassir al-idham. An na'ma qalabaha al-kathir ila naqma. An al-thu'ban al-ladhi yaldagh al-insan. An al-hisan al-ladhi yahmilka ila jannatin aw ila al-niran. An al-sayf al-ladhi qata'a unq sahiba ala wahwa اللسان. So therefore today's speech is about a piece of meat that has no bones in it, but it can break our bones. It is about a blessing, a lots of people turn it to be a curse. It is about the snake that often bites people. It is about the horse that takes you, carries you to the Jannah or dumps you into the hellfire, wal-iyadu billah. It is about the sword that can cut you fast and easy, and that is the tongue. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam declared, أملك عليك لسانك وليسعك بيتك وابكي على خطيئتك. رواه الترمذي. Closest to the meaning, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is telling us, urging us, get a grip of your tongue. Be busy in your home with good deeds. Be busy in privacy with good deeds, away from evil deeds, and cry for your sins. Cry for your sins. So Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam really urging us to get a grip on our tongue. Means to take our tongue for a ride, or the tongue will take us for a ride. No, we can't allow our tongue to take us for a ride. We control our tongue. Question here, my brothers, my sisters. When is the last time our tongue knocked the door on our heart and said, have you cried lately for your sins? When is the last time our tongue asked our heart, have you cried lately for your sins? Take a look at this hadith of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم that's narrated by Al-Bukhari. This is a very important hadith, dangerous hadith. يقول صلى الله عليه وسلم إن الرجل لا يتكلم بالكلمة من رضوان الله ما كان يظن أنها تبلغ ما بلغت يكتب الله بها رضوانه إلى يوم القيامة. This is amazing. وإن الرجل لا يتكلم بالكلمة من سخط الله يكتب الله بها سخطه إلى يوم القيامة. Closest to the meaning, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم told us in this hadith narrated by Al-Bukhari that the man will be speaking one word that pleases Allah, and of course this applies to a sister, to a woman. A man will be saying one word that pleases Allah and he does not know how far it reached. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will put down that he is pleased with him or with her till the day of judgment. That one word you say, maybe one sentence you say, but Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said one word that Allah will put down that he is pleased with you, will conclude that he is pleased with you till the day of judgment. That's it. It's put down, concluded that Allah is pleased with you till the day of judgment. The rest of the hadith, dangerous. That a man will be saying one word from the curse of Allah, Allah will put his curse upon him till the day of judgment. Dangerous hadith. Ulquma said that this hadith, hadith ibn al-Harith, prevented me from saying so many things. Very, very dangerous. Take a look also at Imam al-Nawawi. What did he say? He said, اعلم أنه يجب على كل مكلف أن يحفظ لسانه من جميع الكلام إلا ما تظهر منه المصلحة وإن استوى الكلام وتركه في المصلحة فالسنة الإمساك عنه أي الإمساك عن الكلام فقد يجر الكلام المباح إلى حرام. His statement is completed. Imam al-Nawawi, who said that you have to know it is a must for every mature person to hold his tongue, and that means her tongue as well, to hold the tongue from all type of attack except what it has benefit. And if the benefit of talking equal the benefit of not talking at all, if the benefit of talking equal the benefit of not talking at all, sunnah requires you not to talk, because a halal talk can lead to a haram talk. Very dangerous, my brothers, my sisters. Ibn al-Qayyim, may Allah be pleased with him, said, إن العبد يأتي يوم القيامة بحسنات أمثال الجبال فيجد لسانه قد هدمها كلها ويأتي بسيئات أمثال الجبال فيجد لسانه قد هدمها كلها من كثرة ذكر الله. Closest to the meaning, Ibn al-Qayyim told us, may Allah be pleased with him, that a servant will come in the day of judgment with so many good deeds, huge as a mountain, and he, and that also means she, will find his tongue destroyed all the good deeds, all the hasanat, wipe them out, cancel them. And a person will come in the day of judgment with evil deeds as high as mountains, and he will find his tongue cancel them all, because that tongue is busy with the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with dhikrullah and much more. Truly, my brothers, my sisters, some of us will go to the supermarket and we'll check what's this halal haram ingredients. We could prevent our tongue from eating haram or drinking haram, but sometimes we can't prevent our tongue from destroying our hasanat, our good deeds, from canceling them. It is a serious, dangerous matter. And that's why Ibn Mas'ud, may Allah be pleased with him, said that nothing on the face of earth requires a long-term jail more than the tongue. فما في الأرض شيء أحوج من طول سجن من اللسان. This Ibn Mas'ud, may Allah be pleased with him, said that nothing on the face of earth requires a long-term jail more than the tongue. Now take a look, my brothers, my sisters, at hadith Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم that's narrated, رواه أحمد. He said to Abi Dharr al-Ghathari, may Allah be pleased with him, عليك بطول الصمت فإنه مطردة للشيطان وعون لك على أمر دينك. Closest to the meaning, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, the engineer of happiness. Speaking of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, my brothers, my sisters, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم could solve the problem of this whole world while he's sitting down having a cup of milk. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم in his grave, the teaching and the guidance of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم is available there for whoever wants to link to the happiness and the guidance of Islam. Told Abi Dharr al-Ghufari, get a grip of long silence, means keep quiet for a long time. It help you with the matter of your deen, with the matter of your faith, and it will kick away the shaitan. Indeed, it does kick away the shaitan, my brothers, my sisters, to control the tongue, to preserve the tongue, to take our tongue and to monitor our tongue. It does really kick the shaitan. And really, this khutbah could be titled as your tongue, your happiness or your misery. Indeed, your happiness or your misery. Take a look at the pious generation. An example, Tawus bin Kaysan, may Allah be pleased with him. He used to say, لَقَدْ جَرَّبْتُ لِسَانِي فَوَجَدْتُهُ لَئِيمًا رَاضِعًا. This is a pious imam. He used to say, I have tried my tongue and I found him rigid, has no mercy. Another one, Abdullah bin Zakariya. He said, إِنْ ذَكَرْتُمُ اللَّهَ أَعَنَّاكُمْ وَإِنْ ذَكَرْتُمُ النَّاسَ تَرَكْنَاكُمْ. Closest to the meaning, he said, if you mention Allah, I will sit down and I will help you. And if you are mentioning people and gossiping about people, I will leave you. Another big winner, which is, we mentioned Abdullah bin Zakariya ibn Abbas. What did he say? He said, قُلْ خَيْرًا تَسْلَمْ وَاسْكُتْ عَنْ شَرٍ تَغْنَمْ بَلَغَنِي أَنَّ الْعَبْدَ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ لَيْسَ هُوَ أَحْمَقْ عَلَى شَيْءٍ مِنْ عَلَى لِسَانَهُ. Closest to the beginning, he said that say good, you will gain. Say no evil, you will have no vain. I have been told that a servant in the day of judgment, he is not more upset about anything more than his tongue. That means my sister and my brothers, a male or a female, he will not be more upset about anything more than being upset at his tongue. وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. Ibn Wahb has an interesting story. May Allah be pleased with him. He made a commitment, a penalty, self-penalty, that if his tongue get loose, he will fast one day. If he gossip, he will fast one day as a penalty. But he got tired. He quit that particular penalty. He said, if I gossip one day, I will pay one dirham, suppose $1. If my tongue gets loose, I will fast. But he couldn't handle the fasting anymore. So he said, I will pay one dirham. That's supposed to be, let's say, $1. But he loved the dirham so much that he left gossiping. For us, my brothers, my sisters, if we try this technique, that if our tongue get loose, we pay $1 or $5 penalty, maybe by the end of the week, we will have no money left from our salary. May Allah help us to preserve our tongue. May Allah help us to really have a tongue that busy with the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, busy with inviting people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, busy in saying good things, busy defending Islam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the tongue that could be like a shovel. You know, when you shovel snow in winter, that your tongue could shovel good deeds, could shovel nur, light and barakah in your life. My brothers, my sisters, there's something called fasting and something called diet. So if we can't really fast, if we can't keep our tongue in a fasting routine, fasting process, we have to keep it in a diet. Sometimes you have to have a diet with your tongue. So this way we get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Take a look at hadith Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This particular hadith, من كان يؤمن بالله واليوم الآخر فليقل خيرا أو ليصمت. Whoever believes in Allah and the last day shall say good or be quiet. Very successful, simple formula. Unfortunately, some of us now, their tongue is really sparing the kuffar and protecting the kuffar and lashing the Muslims. وَالْعِيَاذِ بِاللَّهِ. I want you to be introduced to this big winner called الربيع. May Allah be pleased with him. الربيع لم تسمع منه كلمة واحدة تعاب. 20 سنة, the closest people to him, they don't hear one bad word from him. They asked him, ألا تذم الناس? Don't you criticize people, الربيع? He said, والله ما أنا على نفسي براض فأذم الناس. إن الناس خافوا الله على ذنوب الناس وأمنوه على ذنوب أنفسهم. Closest to the meaning, الربيع is telling us and giving us a big bonus, big advice. When they asked him, the closest people to him, they said, we never heard one bad word from him for 20 years. Don't you criticize people? Don't you ill speak of people? He said, wallahi, I am not satisfied about myself to criticize people. People feared Allah about the sins of people, about the sins of others, and they thought they are secure with Allah about their own sins. Amazing statement. My brothers, my sisters, we go to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam with this particular hadith narrated by Al-Bukhari by saying, من يضمن لي ما بين لحييه وما بين رجليه أضمن له الجنة. Closest to the meaning, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam is telling us that whoever guarantees for me what's between his chin and what's between his legs, I will guarantee for him the Jannah. Some of us will say, I dipped my tongue into sins. It's too late. No, it's not too late. Go to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who said, At-ta'ib min al-dhanb kama la dhanbala. Whoever repent from a sin as if he, and that means she, never committed it. My brothers, my sisters, also Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us that the collection of people's tongue, the accumulation of people's tongue, could really send them right on their face into the hell fire. So this is not just really a just regular talk. This is a dangerous really matter, that if we are not aware of our tongue can cancel our hasanat, good deeds. Our tongue can really throw us right in our face flat into the hellfire, wal-iyadu billah, and cause us real trouble, that sometimes one word you say, it takes years to clean, or it takes years to wipe out or white out, wal-iyadu billah. The believers, they asked a pious man, how many did you calculate? How many did you pinpoint the shortcoming of Ibn Adam? It's us, the son of Adam. Us. How many? He said, هي أكثر من أن تحصى ولكن الذي أحصيته 8,000 ووجدت خصيلة واحدة إن استعملتها غطت العيوب ألا وهي حفظ اللسان. He said, I counted more than He said, I counted so much, more than that you could count really, but the one I kept pinpointing, which is more than 8,000. So our shortcoming is more than 8,000, and we think we are perfect. Then he said, but I found one particular virtue, one particular good thing, if you use, it will cover all these shortcomings, all of these ayub, and that is preserving the tongue. Preserving the tongue. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala really help us, my brothers, my sisters, to preserve our tongue. Now, we have to exhibit some of the problems. Some of the problems about the tongue. Some of us would really see somebody in trouble, instead of giving them a hand. No, they are really happy that they are in trouble, and they are really sort of gossiping about them. Take a look at this hadith that narrated by At-Tirmidhi. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is showing us, لا تظهر الشماتة بأخيك فيرحمه الله ويبتليك. Don't show shamata. Shamata means ill, happy feeling. Don't show shamata about your brother. Allah might be merciful upon him and put you in his place. So sometimes, really, when we are seeing somebody suffering certain trouble, our tongue really lashes them instead of giving them a hand. And remember the poet who said, لا ينتقن منك اللسان بسوءة فكلك سوءة وللناس أعين وعينك إن أظهرت أو إن أبدت إليك معائبا فدعها وقل يا عين للناس أعين. That means if your tongue notice certain things about the shortcoming of people, remember that you are full of shortcoming and people has tongues. And if your eyes show you certain weakness about people or certain shortcoming, leave it, ignore it, because people also has eyes and you have weakness and shortcoming. My brothers, another matter which is about those who hear something about their Muslim brother or Muslim sister and they are really cool about it, or they are not really saying anything. Unfortunately, sometimes they are even happy about it. They hear somebody lashing their Muslim brothers and sisters with their tongue and they are cool about it and they don't say anything. So my brothers, you take a look at this particular hadith narrated by At-Tirmidhi, showing us that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala here is in charge of a great reward for you. What does that mean? Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم declared, من رد عن مسلم من رد عن أخيه من غيبة كان حقا على الله أن يعتقه من النار. Closest to the meaning, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم is telling us, whoever is preventing, sending away a gossiping against his brother, and that applies to a sister, Allah will put down a right upon him. Who could put something upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Allah will put down a right upon him subhanahu wa ta'ala to relieve you from the hellfire. Somebody could say, oh, I only say one word to prevent a gossip against my sister or a brother. I only said one sentence to defend them and to send back certain evil words against them. Only that 1 minute, Allah would relieve me from the hellfire. Yes. Yes, my brothers, my sisters. Because when you're dealing with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you're dealing with the most merciful. You're dealing with the most kind. You're dealing with the most generous. Subhanalladhi idha a'ta adhash. Glory to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The one, when He gives you, you'll really be amazed. Another problem about the tongue. What's this problem? This problem from certain people would say to you, you know what? I know the intention of that person. And I know what that person's after. They'll use their tongue as a key to the people's heart. You see, I know what that person's really, what kind of a mess in his heart. And I know what kind of things he means in his heart. You use your tongue as a key to the people's heart. Go to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with this hadith that narrated by Al-Bukhari by saying, إِنِّي لَمْ أُؤْمَرْ أَنْ أُنَقِّبْ قُلُوبَ النَّاسِ وَلَا أَشُقُّ بُطُونَهُمْ. closest to the meaning. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم is telling us, I am not commanded to dig into the people's heart or to rip their stomach open. My brothers, my sisters, there's so many problems about the tongue. I will mention a final one. Some of us would say, you know this person, I know about him so and so. And you know this girl, I know so and so. And I could say that about them in their absence, but I could say the same thing 10 times right in their face. And I could say that about them behind their back, and I could say that about them in their face. Go to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who said, this is a dangerous hadith narrated by Muslim, who said, when he was talking to the companion, al-Sahabi, إن كان فيه ما قلت فقد اغتبت وإن لم يكن فقد بهت. If what you said about him, this is Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم telling the companion, if what you said about him truly applies to him, you have committed ghiba, gossiping. And if what you said about him really it does not apply to him, you have committed buhtan, which is buhtan, much greater sin than ghiba, much greater sin than gossiping. It is real transgression. My brothers, my sisters, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala really sincerely to preserve our tongue, to keep our tongue busy with La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, to keep our tongue busy with dhikrullah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This tongue could be our happiness or misery. Wal'iyadu billah. Dear believers, finally, take a look at Al-Hasan al-Basri. Al-Hasan al-Basri, a person came to Al-Hasan al-Basri, pinpointing the finger at him, and he said to him, قَدْ بَلَغَنِي أَنَّكَ اغْتَبْتَنِي. I have been told that you gossiped about me. Al-Hasan al-Basri, may Allah be pleased with him, this pious imam, nice, cool, calm way, say to this accuser, مَا بَلَغَ قَدْرُكَ عِنْدِي أَنْ أُحَكِّمُكَ بِحَسَنَاتِي. That your status is not so high with me that I will leave you in charge of my good deeds. Means if his tongue loose, he will really lose his good deeds. مَا بَلَغَ قَدْرُكَ عِنْدِي أَنْ أُحَكِّمُكَ بِحَسَنَاتِي. Your status is not so high with me that I would leave you in charge of my good deeds. This is another way of telling him that I didn't let my tongue loose. I'm talking about you, so this way I lose my hasanat. The last interesting statement came from Al-Mubarak, may Allah be pleased with him. He said something in a form of exaggeration. It doesn't mean his mom and dad is bad, not at all. He loves his mom and dad, but he said this particular statement in a form to get the point right to your heart, to drive the point right to your brain, to really pinpoint what he means. Form of exaggeration. He said, لو كنت مغتاب أحد لغتبت والدي لأنهم أحق بحسناتي. If I were to gossip about anyone, I would gossip against my parents. Why? Because they are the best who deserve my good deeds, my hasanat. It doesn't mean his parents is bad, not at all. But he means if his tongue gets loose, he lose hasanat. He lose his good deeds. He rather lose them to his parents. This is just a form of exaggeration to show how dangerous is the tongue. My brothers, my sisters, finally, please remember, a listener can be much better than a speaker. Remember us in your dua. Jazakum Allah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah wa barakatuh.